Moving his head. Bargain?
Test drive.
Where's an advisor?
They don't pester you, you pester them. There's one.
Nice guy. I thought we'd be really desperate, you know, like my ex. Was he more like...
The Car People. The hassle-free way to buy a car.
Kids out of their coat, the way the babies haven't been born. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, dirt road, deep snow, watching the fire as we grow. Oh,
oh. Okay, chaps. You've got 5 minutes. Please, no questions.
At Focus, there's 50% off this Havana 7-piece wooden garden set. Now only $149.99. Focus, famous for low prices.
10 celeb hacks. Have just a week to knock up a glossy mag.
This isn't like a 9-to-5 office job. This is work till we get that magazine out.
Under the mild-mannered Janet Street Porter.
We've got to make this as professional as possible.
As the sackings have started.
Run!
Who will be next to go?
Oh, my battery's gone. I'll be fired next week, and I deserve to be.
It's a dog-eat-dog world.
Deadline, Wednesday and Thursdays at 10, ITV2.
A star-studded audience are invited to come on down as Vernon Kay hosts a brand new series of Game Show Marathon. But first, Harry Hill's got something to bring up.
Constipated ice cream machine finally gets some relief on Wag's Boutique.
Oh, that's better.
Hard handshake makes hairband come off on Marbella Bells.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Don't worry about it. It's not that bad.
And Sylvester Stallone's mum, Jackie, turns up on Doctor Who. We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. I don't know about you, but I love my dogs. I like to buy my dogs things, trinkets and gadgets or whatever, dress them up in doggy clothes, spend a fortune. I'd buy anything for my dogs.
People love their dogs, and so much so that they will spend a fortune on trinkets and gadgets or whatever for their dog. Now, I want you to come up with something very, very special, something innovative that these nutters will go out and buy.
Charming, that is. It's The Apprentice! And their task this week was to design an item for a dog. So, let's have a look at some of the girls' ideas for doggy products.
We all love our dogs, but what is it that's awkward about them? They poo everywhere, they wee everywhere. So I'm going from the angle from the kids thing. Can we have some kind of nappy?
Do you want to use the potty? Hmm? Do you want to use the potty?
Oh! Oh, I just changed her as well. Oh, I could do with some fresh air.
This is going to sound a bit stupid, but a dog-operated fan.
Turn the fan on. Turn the fan on. Turn it on. Good girl. There's a little rusk for you. So, what did the girls settle on? Well, after much umming and ahhing, they came up with the dog...
A coffin. A dog coffin.
No, it was a kind of dog wardrobe. That's the girls. But what of the boys?
One second, I just had a superb idea.
Say it. Is it gone?
Okay, carry on, sorry.
Eventually, the boys came up with a pooch pouch.
And what's its main selling point?
The actual concept of the pooch pouch itself is that you've got a product here that, first of all, doesn't exist.
It doesn't exist. Yeah. Great. I won't have 2,000 of them. And can I not have them by the end of the week? You know when you get your spring roll mixed up with your cigar? Yes, celebrity wife swap is back. And stepping up to the plate were indeed husband and wife of 18 years, Paul Daniels and Debbie McGee. That's tragic. And Vanessa Feltz and, Ben someone.
She and Ben Afeidu have been caught up in a whirlwind romance.
We've been engaged for precisely 4 weeks and we've really been going out, properly going out in love and all of that for about 4 months, that's all, isn't it?
Hang on a minute, they're not even married. He's not a celebrity. It's celebrity wife swap, not non-celebrity fiancé swap. It eats at the very premise of the show. But who cares, as long as there's some arguments. Ben is 10 years younger than Vanessa, so how does the relationship work?
I think our relationship works because we both like to talk and I like to listen as well and talk, and you like to listen, and talk. And in fact, Vanessa talks more than me, but she also listens more.
You talk more than me.
Do you think?
Oh, yeah.
Just shut up the pair of you, will you? Hey? I'll hardly get a word in edgeways. I'm sure a lot of us were fascinated to see what Paul Daniels is up to now.
And what about ambition? Are you still as ambitious as ever you were?
I really would like to be in a movie.
He wasn't a movie, wasn't he? Lord of the Rings. He played Gollum. Things didn't go entirely smoothly. Oh, good. You see, Vanessa's used to living in London with all the excitement therein. Madame Tussauds, London Dungeon, the Aberdeen Steakhouse. Yum, yum. And was a little bored out in the country with Paul. So naturally, she was thrilled to see anyone. Just imagine, you're a gardener, quietly going about your business when...
There is a person over there. Hello!
I could have sworn that's Vanessa Feltz.
I'm ecstatic to see you. I don't care what your name is or who you are.
Yeah, it is Vanessa Feltz. Leave it, Vanessa. Sure, you can manage without her for a couple of weeks. Dale now, and things started to get saucy between Jimmy King and Kelly Windsor.
Is that what I think it is?
Yeah. What? Do you beg your pardon? Elsewhere, Scarlett Nichols had tracked down her dad. It seemed he was hiding in a bush all along.
How old are you?
16.
My dad's in there.
They seem to be making a few budget cutbacks on Emmerdale. They appeared to be using the same actor to play Lisa Dingle and Eddie Hope.
Can I get you a drink?
There he is. There she is. Hey, it's the same actor. They got the same face. You know when your woolly hat tries to sneak off without you wearing it?
Look, Dad, you wouldn't mind giving us a few minutes, would you?
Why?
Those sneaky woolly hats. Oi, where do you think you're going? I know those woolly hats, they're so sneaky. Well, I was most interested... I was most interested to see that... That's enough! Oh, let that be a lesson to all you woolly hats. I was most interested to see a window that looks like a cream slice on Emmerdale this week.
Yeah, Andy, what happened?
I'm ashamed or something.
Mm, yum, yum. Which brings us to our not very good banner of the week. Not very good banner of the week. Holby now, and it's amazing what you can learn from some of these medical shows, isn't it? I learned this week that the body has pairs of things, and that if something happens to one of the pair, often you can make do with just the one.
The great thing about the human body is that we can lose bits without too many problems. It provides pairs, eyes, arms, legs, kidneys, lungs. If one goes, we always have a backup.
can still breathe. Oh, brilliant. Oh, the stuff you learn on Holby.
A tip from you, ladies. Never knit in a car.
Never knit in a car! You know, I hadn't thought about that before. I was knitting while I was driving the other day. Well, the police car pulled up level with me and said, pull over. To which I replied, no, a pair of socks. Allow me one. Back to Holby. There was a school reunion that had gone wrong, and many of the old friends were meeting again for the first time in years.
So, what about you?
Oh, I've got Fergus and my charity work. I don't need anything else.
So, when am I going to meet this Fergus? Is he coming in to collect you?
Oh, I very much doubt it. Fergus is a cat.
Yeah, Fergus is a cat. Very unlikely that a cat would come and pick you up.
Harry, car's here.
Yeah, I'll be 20 minutes, Fergus, all right. Elsewhere in the casualty department of Holby General, there were the usual accidents. And you know, some people say the accidents are a little far-fetched. I disagree. So often in life, just when you think nothing worse can happen, it does. Any worse than falling out of a tree with a chainsaw than a branch of the tree that you were cutting falling on top of you, can it? Another big dilemma at Holby General this week.
Just one final question. Spandau Ballet or Duran Duran?
Spandau Ballet or Duran Duran? Which is better? There's only one way to find out.
Every sofa in the Alan collection is half price. Wouldn't it be great if everything was half price? Just think of all the stuff you could get. Well, unfortunately, in the real world, good stuff doesn't normally come half price. Unlike the sofas and chairs in the Alan collection at DFS, where everything is half price this Easter. There's also 4 years free credit and a whole year payment free. So until you can afford all that other stuff, dream about it on a great sofa from DFS at half the price.
Over bridge of sights, to rest my eyes in shades of green, under dreaming spires, to Ichiku Park, that's where I've been.
What did you do there?
I got high.
What did you feel there?
Well, I cried.
But why the tears there?
Tell you why. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful. It's all too beautiful.
Two new fragrances, one for him,
one for her. CKNTU, Calvin Klein. This is the best of the Proclaimers. 21 rousing anthems from Scotland's finest.
I'm on my way.
Including I'm on my way, I'm gonna be, and Letter from America. Best of the Proclaimers. It's out now.
Sigmund Freud, Carl Jung, Anne-Marie Brentano, giants of the 20th century. It was Professor Brentano who discovered the part of the female brain that makes women act irrationally about shoes, the slingback synapse. She found that enforced waiting inflames the synapse.
Another 3 minutes.
As does failure to deliver the correct size or style.
Bring out another wrong shoe, one size too big.
With disastrous consequences.
You see, classic shoe range.
Her work forms the basis of the shop that bears her name. The shop where the shoes are arranged by size, out in pairs, ready to try on. Brentano, mad about shoes, sane about shopping.
At Halfords now, amazing sat-nav deals. Like this Navman, only £129.99. With touchscreen control and free setup and demo at Halfords now.
The Benson's for Beds half-price Easter sale is now on with extra discounts on selected models. Like this solid iron king-size artisan bedstead, half price. And now with an extra £50 off, only £249.99. And with our exciting range of bedsteads and famous brand beds and mattresses, many at half price. Plus interest-free credit available, there's something for everyone. But hurry, these extra discounts must end Tuesday.
Hello, I'm Vernon Kerr, and I'm here to build excitement and anticipation around the return of the Game Show Marathon. With Game Show Marathon classics such as Bullseye and new favourites, Mr. and Mrs. Be nice to each other. And blankety blank. Checkbook and pen! A brand new series of Game Show Marathon right after TV Burp.
Woo! Yeah!
Welcome back to TV Burp. Hungry flea put out of its misery on EastEnders. Vanessa Feltz leaves her pants on the bed on Interior Rivalry. And Doctor Who forgets to tip pizza delivery boy. The Jane Austen season continued with Persuasion. Not to be confused with the Roger Moore, Tony Curtis vehicle, The Persuaders. And I spotted a huge finger with green nail varnish on it. It could be you. Like all the period dramas, Persuasion showed us the habits and customs of olden times, such as the now long-forgotten role of the ink maid. Yeah, you were writing a letter and wanted to fill your pen. Always, there was the ink maid. And you know when you're not sure whether to bite someone or kiss them? I'll kiss him. I'll bite him. I'll kiss, kiss, bite. I'll kiss. Bite, 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 kiss, kiss, bite, 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 kiss, bite, kiss, bite, 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 but kiss. EastEnders now, where even the lampposts were feeling sad.
I knew it. How sad can you get?
I've had a bad week. The Rob, May, Dawn love triangle finally came to a peak this week, and once Rob had broken away from May, he had a real spring in his step. He was acting crazy, throwing away a perfectly good laptop.
Rob, you get back here this instant!
Do you not understand English? I'm leaving you!
What?
I don't know what your hormones are telling you, but I'm honest saying I want to spend the rest of my life with you.
Are you for real?
What does it look like?
So what you got that then for?
I don't know. I just picked it up. I don't know what I'm doing with it. I think I'm going a bit crazy. I don't care. I don't care about anything anymore.
You're lucky laptop. You might think Rob's spurned wife May would be upset, but instead she decided to unwind with a game of crazy golf. the windmill. Meanwhile, Phil was giving Ben an acting masterclass.
I mean, 9 times out of 10, you don't even have to raise a fist. You know, if they think you're trouble, they'll steer clear of you. It's about giving them the look.
What's the look?
What do you mean, what's the look?
Often, if you're nipping to the shops or popping into a friend for coffee, it's convenient to leave your Deirdre in the car. Well, she did it. But if you do decide to leave your Deirdre in the car, make sure you leave a window open.
What can you say?
Deirdre's die in hot cars. Yes, it's our own Coronation Street. And poor Deirdre, her daughter on trial for murder. Still, the jury seemed a varied bunch.
Today, you may think that you must have accurate and reliable evidence.
Black, white, Chinese, Sikh. What's this? A Benetton advert? And that's only half of them. Here's the rest. French woman, German, rabbi, pope. Ku Klux Klan on the end. I think we were all completely bowled over with surprise when the verdict finally came.
Have the jury reached a verdict on which they are all agreed?
Yes, we have.
Do they find the defendant, Tracy Lynette Barlow, guilty or not guilty of murder?
Guilty.
Lynette? She kept that quiet. Born survivor now. And this week, Bear was in Sierra Nevada and, as ever, had the usual need for food.
The most difficult part is catching them.
But you can see the abdomen there, and you can eat that. And that's kind of really tingy and sweet.
Ooh, I'm full. I couldn't eat another ant's abdomen. Ooh. What about a nice hot drink?
But like any true Englishman, my day starts with a hot cup of tea. This one, however, is brewed with pine needles.
Well, it's not tea then, is it? Hey? I tell you what, Bear's got some stories.
There was actually a teenage Girl Scout who recently came out, lost her bearings, and she was lost for 2 days in the end.
2 days, really?
A few years ago, a teenage climber from Michigan slipped on a wet patch of similar rock on a nearby mountain. He fell and broke his ankle.
Broke his ankle?
Recently, an injured hiker was stuck out here for a week. Helicopter searching for him couldn't see him under the trees.
Couldn't see him under the trees. It's almost as if you can't get away from him and his stories.
He got lost, got heat stroke, disorientated, and within 24 hours, he was dead.
Shocking.
He was just quarter of a mile from the road.
Quarter of a mile.
And that's how easy it is.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, I give you a shower door that sounds like an elephant. This was Channel 4's Chaos at the Chateau, in which Anne and David Darrell sell their Essex home and convert a Slovakian chateau into a hotel. And like any good hotel, the food is so important, particularly the house speciality.
Thierry. We got a special tonight?
Yes, we have Akmus tonight for dinner. That's special. You know, it's food.
Akmus?
Yeah.
What's in it, Akmus?
Akmus.
Mm-hmm.
Akmus?
What the hell is Akmus?
Hake moose.
Hake moose?
Hake moose.
That is Akmus.
Yeah, he's French. What's wrong with you?
Of course, hake moose. I've got the rest of the chateau menu here. Yeah, let's have a look. Well, there's hake moss, obviously. That's there. Then there's smoked salmon. then there's prawn cocktail. This is a prawn cocktail. And then the main course is ant's abdomen. Just going back, how's that hack moss served? Oh, I see, spheres of hack moss. Yeah. Ooh, I might get some of those for my party. Well, I love a party with some lovely hack moss spheres. Ever heard of that condition, nun phobia, where you're scared of nuns?
Jimmy. Jimmy, come on. Jimmy.
It's the Royal, and like its sister show Heartbeat, it's all in the music of the 60s. And every now and then, we're treated to real-life 60s stars getting ill and dropping into hospital. And this week, it was the turn of that household favourite...
Dorcas sets off on tour with her group, the Dreamboats.
Dorcas, of course. We all remember Dorcas with her hits, Oh, and, what does she do exactly? She's a singer, right? Doesn't actually sing, but she must do more than that. I mean, does she speak?
Thank you, I love you all.
Wow, that's quite a show. What does she do for an encore? Bravo! I know a lot of you will be thinking, ah, whatever happened to Dorcas? She'd be in her 60s now. Well, we've tracked her down. Ladies and gentlemen, to play us out, it's Dorcas!
Next on ITV1.
Hello, I'm Vernon Kay, and Game Show Marathon is back. And we've got six celebrities all hoping to win big for their favourite charity. They'll be playing super smashing games like Bullseye. 180! And they're all aiming for the grand final, and one of them will be declared the Game Show Marathon champion. Woo! Yes!
WBO Super Middleweight Champion. 42 fights.